Service Teardown, HP Z8 Fury G5 Workstation Desktop. How to replace the faceplate. Removal. Release the two latches on the bottom of the unit and then pull the faceplate away from the unit and remove. Replacement. Place the top tabs of the faceplate into the cutouts on the unit and then lower the faceplate against the unit until the bottom latches are secure. How to replace the side cover. Removal. Lift the handle on the side cover, pull away from the unit, and then remove. Replacement. Place the bottom edge of the side cover into the cutout on the unit and lift until the side cover latches into place. How to replace the service doors. Before you begin, remove the side cover. Removal. Open the top service door by the blue touch point. Rotate the service door latches out of the chassis cutouts and remove. Repeat the process to remove the bottom service door. Replacement. Insert the top service door latches into the cutouts on the chassis and rotate to secure. Close the service door by the blue touch point. Repeat the process to replace the bottom service door. How to replace the power supply unit. Warning: to avoid personal injury and damage to the product, use extreme care not to puncture, twist, or crack the battery. An internal puncture or rupture to the battery has the potential to cause a short, which may result in a thermal event. Removal. Push down on the PSU release latch by the blue touch point, slide the power supply unit out of the chassis, and remove. Repeat the process to remove the additional power supply unit. Replacement. Insert the power supply unit into the cutout on the rear of the unit, making sure to note the correct alignment, and then slide the PSU until it clicks into place. Repeat the process to install the additional power supply unit. How to replace the RTC battery. Before you begin, remove the side cover and service doors. Warning: to avoid personal injury and damage to the product, use extreme care not to puncture, twist, or crack the battery. An internal puncture or rupture to the battery has the potential to cause a short, which may result in a thermal event. Removal. Carefully push in on the metal tab on the battery slot until the RTC battery is released. Lift the RTC battery off the motherboard and remove. Replacement. Place the RTC battery in position on the battery slot on the motherboard. Push down on the RTC battery until it clicks in place to secure it. How to replace the GPU. Before you begin, remove the side cover and service doors. Removal. Push in on the blue release lever and carefully lift the GPU straight up out of the PCIe slot on the motherboard and remove. Replacement. Position the GPU in place over the motherboard and lower into position until secure in the PCIe slot. How to replace the PCIe retainer with fan. Before you begin, remove the side cover and service doors. Removal. Push in on the two blue touch points, lift the air baffle out of the connector on motherboard, and remove. Replacement. Position the air baffle over the motherboard and then lower it into the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the system memory. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Release the latches on both sides of the RAM slot. Lift the system memory off the motherboard and remove. Replacement. Insert the system memory into the connector on the motherboard. Press down on the system memory to lock into place. How to replace the rear system fan. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Disconnect the rear system fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Push down on the system fan release tabs on the back of the chassis to release the system fan. Lift the system fan off the chassis and remove. Replacement. Insert the system fan's bottom tabs into the cutouts on the chassis and rotate the rear system fan up until it locks into place. Reconnect the rear system fan cable to the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the front system fan. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Disconnect the mid-system fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Disconnect the front fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Push down on the front system fan and pull away from the chassis to disengage the latches. Lift the front system fan out of the chassis and remove. Replacement. Place the front system fan in position in the chassis. Press down on the top of the front system fan and insert the fan latches into the chassis cutouts. Reconnect the front fan cable to the connector on the motherboard. Reconnect the mid-system fan cable to the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the hard drive. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Lift the release latch by the blue touch point on the applicable hard drive cage. Slide the hard drive cage out of the chassis by the release handle and remove. Pull the sides of the hard drive tray away from the hard drive to release the pins and separate the hard drive from the hard drive tray. Replacement. Place the hard drive into the hard drive tray and ensure the pins on the hard drive tray are inserted into the hard drive. Insert the hard drive cage into the empty hard drive bay on the chassis. Push down on the release latch until it clicks into place. How to replace the optical disk drive. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, PCIe retainer with fan, and front system fan. Removal. Disconnect the power cable from the connector on the optical disk drive. Disconnect the SATA cable from the connector on the optical disk drive. Lift up on the chassis release latch and push the optical disk drive out the front of the chassis and remove. Replacement. Insert the optical disk drive into the front of the chassis. Lift up on the chassis release latch and push the optical disk drive in until secure. Reconnect the SATA cable to the connector on the optical disk drive. Reconnect the power cable to the connector on the optical disk drive. How to replace the upper system fan. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Pull up on the tab on the top plastic cover and slide to the left to release, and then remove. Push down on the upper system fan and pull away from the chassis to disengage the latches. Slightly lift the upper system fan off the chassis and disconnect the upper fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Lift the upper system fan out of the unit and remove. Replacement. Place the upper system fan in position in the chassis. Reconnect the upper fan cable to the connector on the motherboard. Press down on the top of the upper system fan and insert the fan latches into the chassis cutouts. Insert the top plastic cover into the cutouts on the chassis and slide to the right to secure. how to replace the front I/O port assembly. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, PCIe retainer with fan, and upper system fan. Removal. Disconnect the audio cable from the cable connector. Disconnect the power cable from the connector on the USB daughterboard. Disconnect the front USB cable from the connector on the USB daughterboard. Lift up on the chassis release latch, push the front I/O port assembly out the front of the chassis, and remove. Replacement. Insert the front I/O port assembly into the front of the chassis, lift up on the chassis release latch, and push the USB daughterboard in until secure. Reconnect the front USB cable to the connector on the USB daughterboard. Reconnect the power cable to the connector on the USB daughterboard. Reconnect the audio cable to the cable connector. How to replace the CPU heatsink. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, power supply unit, RTC battery, and PCIe retainer with fan. Removal. Disconnect the heatsink power cable from the connector on the motherboard. Note, the heatsink module has numbers adjacent to the following four screws. Loosen the four captive T30 Torx screws that secure the heatsink to the motherboard in numerical order. Lift the locking bar on each captive screw to the vertical position. Carefully lift the heatsink off the motherboard and remove. Replacement. Position the heatsink in position over the motherboard and lower into position on the alignment pins. Lower the locking bar on each captive screw to the angled position to lock them. Note, the heatsink module has numbers adjacent to the following four screws. Tighten the four captive T30 Torx screws that secure the heatsink to the motherboard. Reconnect the heatsink power cable to the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the motherboard. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, PCIe retainer with fan, system memory, GPU, rear system fan, front system fan, upper system fan, and heatsink. Removal. Disconnect the following cables from the motherboard. SATA cables, PCI power cable, main power cable, FUI power cable, front USB cable, interlock right cable, CPU power cable, interlock left cable, secondary CPU power cable, front audio cable. Slide the motherboard away from the rear of the chassis to disengage it from the chassis. Carefully lift the motherboard off the chassis and remove. Replacement. Caution: take care not to trap any of the cables between the motherboard and display panel assembly. Place the motherboard in position on the chassis. Slide the motherboard toward the rear of the chassis to lock it into the chassis. Reconnect the following cables to the motherboard. Front audio cable. Secondary CPU power cable. Interlock left cable. CPU power cable. Interlock right cable. Front USB cable. FUI power cable. Main power cable. PCI power cable. SATA cables. How to replace the power distribution board. Before you begin, remove the side cover, service doors, PCIe retainer with fan, system memory, GPU, rear system fan, front system fan, upper system fan, heatsink, and motherboard. Removal. Remove the two T15 Torx screws that secure the side cover to the chassis. Lift and remove the side cover. disconnect the power cable from the cable connector. Remove the four T15 Torx screws that secure the power board to the chassis. Lift the power board off the chassis. Guide the cables through the openings in the chassis and remove. Replacement. Guide the power board cables into the cutouts on the chassis and place the power board in place on the chassis. Replace the four T15 Torx screws that secure the power board to the chassis. Reconnect the power cable to the cable connector. Insert the bottom edge of the side cover into the chassis. Replace the two T15 Torx screws that secure the side cover to the chassis. Click the Playlists tab in YouTube to find HP videos in other languages. And search our channel to find official HP support videos.